In this set of videos, we'll explore the basic sounds of American English, and we'll introduce a basic distinction used in all study of speech sounds, the difference between the phonetic level and the phonological level. The primary goals of this section will be to understand the basic definitions of the term phonology and phonetics, and to develop a basic idea of how these two are different. We'll also discuss basic transcription terminology, drawing a distinction between broad and narrow transcription, and noting that the same segment of speech could be transcribed in multiple different ways, depending on your need for differing levels of detail. All of the basic consonant and vowel sounds of English will be introduced using common organizational frameworks, such as two-dimensional charts. And finally, we'll examine the types of features that sounds might share, ultimately developing a taxonomic classification system that shows how sounds can relate to each other by sharing certain features, or differ from each other by having different feature specifications. So let's dive right in. At its most basic level, phonetics is the study of speech sounds and how they're produced. It's a very broad field of study, and as described in an earlier video, it's often broken down into three areas: articulatory phonetics, acoustic phonetics, and linguistic phonetics. Within these descriptors of the field overall, the specific tool of phonetic transcription serves different functions. It's important to keep in mind that the transcription part of phonetics is just one tool that's used in the study of phonetics. We spend a lot of time developing transcription skills because these skills require a new way of thinking about how we write words. In essence, phonetic transcription is a new spelling system, which employs some letters that work the way you expect them to, other letters that might surprise you with how they work in phonetic transcription, and still other letters that you likely have never seen before, so you have to learn them from scratch. Because many students come into the study of phonetics with well-learned skills and standard spelling, it can take a lot of practice to develop the skills that are required to represent words using this new transcription system. So in this course, there will be lots of practice transcribing sounds, words, phrases, and sentences. But keep in mind that the study of phonetics goes well beyond questions of how to transcribe something. The transcription, really, is just the beginning of an inquiry into how sounds function within speech. Some of those questions will go beyond the scope of this course, but I encourage you to cultivate the sense of inquiry that'll take you beyond the basics of transcription in the end. We often draw a distinction between phonetics and phonology, and this distinction can be confusing for many students who are new to this field of study. When we talk about phonology, or of a phonological level of representation, what we mean is that we're talking about how patterns of sounds work within a language. In other words, sounds relate to each other in particular ways, and one of the interesting things about the study of languages is to see how different languages might make use of the same sounds, but have them relate to each other in different ways. So when we talk about phonology, we'll be talking about the way sounds work in a specific language. In addition, we'll be looking for regular patterns among sounds that show up within a given language. Because these patterns are regular, we can predict how sounds will behave within that language. And where we have this kind of predictability, we refer to these kinds of identified patterns as rules. In using this term, what we mean is that speakers of a language use sounds in predictable, regular ways, even though they might not be aware that they're doing so. In fact, this is one of the most interesting areas of the study of language. One might think that if a speaker didn't even know about a pattern, then they wouldn't be able to apply that pattern regularly. But language is full of examples of rules that speakers apply consistently and reliably, without showing any awareness that there even is a rule. Many speakers will even explicitly deny the existence of the rule, and they'll similarly state that even though other speakers might talk that way, they would never talk that way. But one of the most interesting things about these linguistic rules is that people overwhelmingly do employ such rules. In fact, their rules are best demonstrated when they're not even thinking about whether they apply the rules. So the level of phonology is concerned with two special types of relationships that sounds can have within a language. where that relationship is described as a rule, we say that those sounds have an allophonic relationship. The sounds are different allophones. And where sounds are used to convey changes in meaning, we say that those sounds are in a phonemic relationship. Those sounds are separate phonemes. We'll cover some examples in later movies, but for now, just keep in mind that the difference between a phonemic and an allophonic relationship is a central concern of phonology.